Hard one to take, Kevin, to be ahead so late on and lose the game.
Aye, listen, I think anybody who's at the game, I think the pressure was coming. No, didn't they? You know, the numerous chances and the boys throwing themselves in the line and boys putting their bodies on the line, and Callum's had a couple of great saves. But it's always hard to take when you lose so late. But listen, we've got to take it. We've got to take it in the chin, and we've got to make sure we bounce back and really and show that togetherness. It's been a massive part of the good run we've been on. It's not the end of a good run. It's how you bounce back to defeat. You know, if we go and give a positive performance, then we've lost 2-14 or whatever it is. You know what I mean? So, not necessarily the end of a good run. Hopefully, the start of a new run.
Given the chances you created, you feel you should have taken something from the game, though.
I thought Elgin created a lot of chances as well. You know, we did. We created some chances, but Elgin had equal amount. I would say. I wouldn't say we were miles ahead in that department. But the goals we lose were really bad goals. Really bad goals. The third goal, I'm not sure about. I'd have to look at that again. A wee bit of a stramash, but the first two were definitely preventable. But listen, I'm really disappointed. But right now we've had a huge effort, a great run for the players. So what we've got to do is address what went wrong today and regroup. It's been a hard week, but no excuses. You know, we've came to a difficult place. Elgin have, you know, they've proven the better team on the day. We've just got to take it in the chin and lessons learned, hopefully.
Was the third game in a week a factor late on, do you think?
No, I can't use that as an excuse. You know, we've got a fit bunch of laddies there and they've went and gave me everything. Did Elgin look a bit brighter? Probably, but maybe that's with the ascendancy of having two equalising goals. I don't, you know, you could throw the tired excuse around. I don't think that's played a huge part in the game today. I thought we played in spells today, started the game okay, fell out it, come back into it, fell out it, come back into it. And when you do that against better opposition and you give them those chances, they'll punish you sooner or later, you know. And I think we've learned, hopefully, a harsh lesson today. And as I say, I'm hoping the boys have learned it.
And you had warned Elgin, despite losing Shane Sutherland, who was probably the best player, would be dangerous.
Listen, it can galvanise you. You know, what they've lost in a quality player maybe galvanises that team, and maybe people that were in the shadows step up and give 5-10% more. Listen, we've had a hard day, and it's a hard one to take, and I'm really disappointed. But, you know, we've got to be men about it, and there's always another game of football. So we pick ourselves up, dust ourselves down, and we get ready for a huge test on Saturday.
No Darren Smith, was that just to freshen things up, give Darren a bit of a rest?
Aye, listen, you look at it, we went with a front three that's no played an awful lot of football. You know, Dylan 10 minutes, you know, Neely's come in there for the cold, having had two really good impact games, and again showed flashes of really good stuff today. And you know, Max, he's not played a lot of football this season, so should be relatively fresh. So we went with that energy up front. You know, it was a decision I made, and rightly or wrongly, then that's, you know, wrongly today, because we lose the game. So, but whether that's the impact, I don't know. I think, you know, at the other end, we might get things wrong today.
And the change at half-time, was that just Jordan Abidin at his best first half?
No, he was struggling. He was struggling with his body. He was out of sorts, obviously. A few mistakes, but, you know, he was in general struggling with various things for Tuesday night, probably. But again, you know, if you declare yourself fit, then you're good to go, as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. So, you know, a lesson learned for him as well, hopefully.
And two big home games coming up, Peterhead, then Clyde. How do you view those?
Well, listen, there's no better games that you can bounce back from, you know, in terms of having a defeat. You're going against the biggest and best teams in the league. Clyde and Peterhead have proven to be that, so we're under no illusions of what's coming to town, so we need to make sure we're ready, you know, because in spells today it would be good enough, but in other spells it certainly wouldn't be anywhere near good enough to see off these teams. So we've got to bring it together collectively for, you know, the majority of the minutes that we're going to play.
And just one final one, any update on Peter McDonald's injury, how long he might be out for?
No update. We'll just need to assess Peter as the days, and, you know, hopefully not weeks, but certainly as the days go by in terms of next week. So we'll assess him. You know, he'll be in obviously constant contact and be working with Kenny, the physio, and hopefully we'll have something positive by the end of the week. Right now I would be more doubtful than hopeful, but sometimes these things clear up pretty quickly, so it would be nice to have one more to give us a problem getting into the game.